of this episode, we're going to be talking about how to improve a brittle test suite and tests by removing hard-coded variables in your tests. So let's take a look at an example of a brittle test and how we can improve it. So this test right here, we have a person, we send an email to that person, and we want to verify that the email goes to the correct email address and has the correct subject line. So at a first glance, this works great. If we run the test for it, you'll see that they pass and everything is good. However, if someone else comes in and changes something that shouldn't affect this test, for example, they change the email address to person1 or person.1@example.com, if we were to run this test again, all of a sudden there's a failure, and the failure is because the email address doesn't match what's in our fixtures. So this test really isn't testing exactly what we want. It's testing that the email is set up with the correct to address, but it's also testing our fixture. So this is saying, hey, we want to make sure that our fixture has this exact value and that our email sets that to it. So our test is really doing more than it seems at a first glance. So a better way of writing this is to say person.email, because we want to verify that the person's email address is used dynamically. So if we pass in a person, we can also use that in our assertions to make sure that that's working. And then we can go and modify this as much as we want, and that will continue to pass. So if we run this test here, it's going to be passing again. So now we can make as many changes to our fixtures, and the actual data in our fixtures doesn't matter with our test suite. And that's very good when you're working with many people who might be modifying your fixtures and changing things accordingly. So you still want that fixture to be relied upon and reliable, but our test was a little bit too brittle with the hard-coded value. And the exact same thing can happen when you have your subject line here. If we were to go and change the person mailer, so let's pull that up, personmailer.rb. Let's change this to hello question mark. If we set that and we go and run our test now, it will fail. And what we can do instead is actually use the locales file to define our subject line here instead. So if we were to go and delete this subject right here, we can go into locales and define person mailer NPS subject in there and define it there. So if we go into locales EN, we want to add person mailer NPS and subject. And here we can say, do you have 60 seconds for a quick question? And that is what we can use for our subject. Now, if we run our test, that should continue to pass. And we can remove this now. And we can say i18n.t and personmailer.nps.subject. This will automatically set the correct locale for us. And we can run our test here. And we're back to passing. Now we can go to that locale file and modify the subject anytime we want, and our test will continue to pass. So this change to the individual test doesn't seem to be that big, but if you apply this to your entire test suite and you add lots of hard-coded things, you might change a simple button text, and that could break 10 or 15 different tests. I've worked on test suites like that in the past, and boy, is it painful. So do yourself a favor, make sure that your tests are testing the code, not so much the test environment's contents itself. You don't want to worry about specific strings and things like that unless you need to make sure that those are exact. In this case, when we're testing fixtures and other dynamic data, we want to make sure that it's dynamic. We don't want to just make sure it matches what's hard-coded in our test suite. It's going to save you a lot of time and make your life a whole lot easier. That's one of the big things of maintaining a good test suite. You need it to be running fast, and you don't want to have to go and fix random tests whenever you make a content change, like changing a simple subject line in an email. So that is it for this episode, and I will talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.